Hustle Premier 2K15. She's a pitcher, shortstop, and third baseman. Let's give a nice round of applause for Sophia Ramirez.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Prairie View Indian University Women's Softball Complex. We are live, getting ready to bring you exclusive coverage of exciting home run hitting championship SWAC softball as Lady Panthers take on the Tigers of Texas Southern in a doubleheader. We want to welcome all of our viewers, all of us on Splendid Media. Go ahead and jump on over to our YouTube page so you can see the video. We kind of went over on yesterday. Today is going to be enforced. So as the game gets ready to get started, we're going to have to turn off the video feed and make sure everybody is on our YouTube channel at PBAMU Athletics on YouTube. About to get this one underway, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a good one. The Panthers coming off of a 7-6 win yesterday as the Tigers came roaring back on the Charles Porter Jinx and almost got ahead of the Panthers. Here's the lineup for the Texas Southern Tigers. Johnson, Zuniga, Garcia, and Morales. In the box for the Tigers of Texas Southern, the center fielder, number 13, Paris Johnson. A lot of stuff to talk about, ladies and gentlemen, on yesterday. We want to send a shout-out to Tamara McDonald. Somewhere in, what, Seabrook? Where are you, dear? Seabrook? Oh, no, it's League City now. That's right. Want to send a shout-out to you. Thanks for watching. Tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10. About exciting Lady Panthers softball. First pitch, Rania on the mound for the Panthers with a strike. Going against Paris Johnson. That one's outside, ball one. 1-2 the count. Third pitch, here's the windup. Nice one, bunt right to Rania, and should be easy, one away. Now batting for Texas Southern, the left fielder, number 11, Deanna Zuniga. Folks, I want to remind you, live stats are available for today's game. All you have to do is go to our website, www.pbpanthers.com. Scroll down to the middle of the page, and you'll see the game live. Go to the right-hand side, click the hamburger. That's those three dots on the right. The drop-down box will come and give you the live stat bar, and you can click it and find out what's going on. For yourself, follow the live stats at www.pbpanthers.com. Here comes pitch number 5, a swing and a foul ball. That one a little high, came across the middle, but just a little high. 1-2 the count here. Oh, asked the third baseman. No, third base ump says she didn't break her wrist. That's going to be ball two. 2-2 the count. One out. Top of the first inning, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just joining us, welcome to another edition of Home Run Hitting Southwestern Athletic Championship Lady Panthers Softball. We're live in the women's softball complex on the campus of Prairie View Indian. That's a swing and a miss. And first strikeout there for Rania. Rania catches a grounder, throws it to first, and then gets a strikeout. First two batters up. Now batting for Texas Southern, the catcher, number 28, Charisma Garcia. That one a little higher on the right side. Well, it's Nikki Williams coming in. Wow. Well, let's see if we can get another great crew going, man. Just want to thank everybody in the press box yesterday, man. I think we had our best go of it this year yesterday, man. Everything was just perfect. Here comes Rania, except for when Charles jinxed him in the seventh inning. That one right across the top there, left corner, a sinker, strike one. 1-1 the count. Two out. That's a strike. Here comes the pitch. It's high. Two balls, two strikes. That one outside is going to make it a full count. Full count. Rania comes in with an ERA of 3.13 on today's game. Earns run average. That one's high. She'll take the base. First walk of the day for Brianna Rania. Here comes the catcher now. The first baseman, Angel Morales. Now batting for the Tigers, the first baseman, number 37, Angel Morales. Right down the middle, Rania's hot. Talked to Coach Vernon Bland and Alexis Bandon in our dugout meet out, so to speak, our meeting right before the game, and we were talking about the pitching, and I'm like, man, we haven't really seen a lot of Johnny plus Erica. I'll tell you about it in a minute. Here comes the pitch. That one slapped up in the middle. Here's chasing it back. Goes, Garcia uncharacteristically misses one. We start off like we did on yesterday with the Tigers scoring in the first inning, 1-0. Garcia just kind of misjudged that one. It hit her glove and went over her head. Yeah, let's watch the replay if we got a chance there. As she was going back, it hit her glove. So Naya Henderson in the box now for Texas Southern.
In the box for the Tigers, number four, the designated hitter, Saniya Henderson.
One and oh the count. Here comes the pitch. It's a grounder right to the second baseman. Tally has it, and that's going to retire the side. And heading to the bottom of the first inning, one run, zero hits, one error, and one left on base. At the end of the top of the first inning, Texas Southern 1, the Panthers 0. Folks, stick around. We'll take a quick break and come back with more exciting women's softball right here from Prairie View, Texas.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
All the way from Navasota, Texas. Let's get her done. The left fielder, Mia Nunes. Panthers first at bat here, ladies and gentlemen, going into the bottom of the first inning. Texas Southern scored one run in the first inning on yesterday. They score one run in the first inning today. And the Panthers getting off to kind of a normal start here. Back to what we were talking about with the pitchers. We've got a corral of pitchers. Oh, Rojas hit by pitch. Not Rojas hit by pitch, but Nunes was hit by the pitch. But back to the pitchers, Rojas and Brianna Reina and, of course, Kalen Massey. And you've got Haley Elizaris, all back there. Maya, what's Maya's last name? Oh, forgive me, Maya. She was one of the best pitchers last year. But anyway, we've got a great bullpen. It's kind of tough to see who we're going to put in there. Now batting for the Panthers, the shortstop, number 24, Destiny Smith. Maya Hall, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Thurston. You know, I was telling my wife last night as we were breaking down the game, I said, boy, you know, me and Ms. Thurston, boy, when we're good, we're good. 0-1 to count. Kind of missed last year. Boy, we had a great season last year. It was just pretty much me and you last year. Here we go. There's the bunt. No, it's behind her, and she'll come back. That'll be strike two. Fig waiting in the wings. Yesterday, Figueroa in the first inning took one over a fence. The two-run homer, is that how it went yesterday, Figueroa, guys? Huh? Thank you, ma'am. Tamara, here comes Destiny. That's a swing and a foul ball. Yesterday, four hits for Destiny Smith. Let me get the stats there and tell you exactly what she did on yesterday. But she was making some connection with the ball on yesterday. I think she threw out at first, a double play, I think, and then a strikeout and two pop flies on yesterday. I mean, the Panthers bat around so much. It's just incredible. There she is, a grounder to the first baseman. They'll get the first base. And she gets there. Man, she puts the afterburners on. Smith gets the first base now. Runner on first base. And Fleming will go take a seat. Now batting for the Panthers. All the way from Natalia, Texas. The catcher, number 10, Bibiana Figueroa. Well, is this not deja vu, Ms. Thurston? We've got a runner on first base. Figueroa's in the box. First inning, bottom of the first inning, and it's 1-0. It's the exact same. No? It was a three-run homer in the first, yes? Okay, golly gee, Willikers. Well, almost deja vu. Deja who? Nikki Williams came over to be cute today from Dallas. Here comes the pitch. Figueroa standing in there. It's a ball. 3-0 the count. Fig doing. That one's inside. Fig will take it first strike. 3-1 the count on deck for the Panthers. The slugger, JD. Here's Figueroa. That one's high. Figueroa's going to take a base. Now we've got two on base with JD in the box. Some come for the atmosphere. I come for the softball. Now batting for the Panthers. The third baseman. Number 21, well, the official stuff, man, I thought I was in trouble. Jalen Davis. The official, well, I didn't get a chance to call her name. The official stopped play before then. That one comes across the middle. It's a strike. What was the comments there? She wasn't in the box completely when she started the windup, or what was the call? Oh, he's kind of, like you said, some officials are particular with the call, so he stopped play. And a swing and a miss. That one kind of curved inside to Davis. One and two the count, folks. Runners at first and second, Figueroa and Smith. Last year, Smith didn't mind getting after stealing the bases, but kind of subdued this year when stealing bases. One and two the count. One out, bottom of the first. Here comes the pitch. A swing and a miss, and J.D. takes a seat. Golly gee, uncharacteristic. That's okay. You come to expect that from your sluggers. Now batting for the Panthers, all the way from Lafayette, Texas. Number 30, Hannah Garza. That one right down the middle. That one's outside and a ball. One and one the count. Trying to find, Miss Thurston, if you could assist me, trying to find the pitch count again. Where did I miss it? I'm at game stats. Folks, if you can, if you want to look at them, I'll walk you through it as I find it. There's a swing and a foul ball. If you go to the live stats, pull them up, you'll see the first little line says game status. If you're trying to go to the pitch count, I'm on game status. Which one plays? Runners at first and second. Oh, okay, here you go. Go down on the, that's going to be ball four, and now we're loaded up. And here comes another slugger who has entered the building. Ladies and gentlemen, now batting for the Panthers. Tamara McKnight. Tamara McKnight, Charles. I was trying to find her. I'm looking at it. Is she the DH in today? What is she doing? Oh, yeah. There's a swing and a foul ball. Yeah, she's the designated hitter. That's what I was looking for. Bless you. Hallelujah. McKnight, man, just a great acquisition. Came from Texas Southern last year. She's only a junior, so she'll have another year with Vernon Bland. Started her career out at San Jacinto. And a force out. Heads up play by the catcher. The Panthers had the bases loaded up. When we talk with Vernon Bland, I'll tell you the keys to the game, and we're not doing that here in the first inning. You got to do a little bit better job here of trying to get going. Scoring first was one of the keys to the game. We got to keep the pressure on the Lady Tigers. Keep scoring, keeping the pressure on them by scoring, and we've got to finish. At the end, ladies and gentlemen, well, let's just do it this way. Going into the top of the second inning, zero runs, two hits, zero errors, and three left on base. At the end of the, pardon me, you got three left on base? You said 0-2, 0-3? 0-0-0-3. Okay, folks, correction. Zero runs, zero hits, zero errors, three left on base. Zero runs, zero hits, zero errors, and three left on base. At the end of the first inning, the score, Texas Southern 1, the Panthers 0. Here's the lineup for the Tigers of Texas Southern. Just trying to make sure, is that number 6 there? Is that going to be Richardson, Perla? Okay, here we go. Richardson, Perla, McLean, and Sweeney. Richardson, Perla, McLean, and Sweeney. Folks are looking at those live stats. If you want to go and look at the pitch count, that we're kind of interested in how many pitches Rania is throwing. Just go to the stat main page where it says game status. And you'll see the score here on the left side, the game line score. And you'll also see the play-by-play on your right-hand side of the game. Right under that, right under the play-by-play and the game line score, you'll see on both sides the number of pitches for both players. Figueroa with a bunt. There's a bunt. A good throw there to the first McKnight, and she's out. First base, that was guards, pardon me. Tally's the thrower, the first baseman is guards, all right? Yeah, there you go. Okay. Okay, Fig to Tally on the play. Here's the look at the play by play there, Charles. There it is right there. Fig by Figueroa to Tally, the backup on the first base. You can see it on the replay. Now I've lost the pitch count again there. Here we go. Rania with the windup. That one's outside. Ball. 0-2 the count. Oh, pardon me, 2-0 the count. Trying to find them. Well, did I lose it again? Here, up there to the right. Perla. That's a strike. I didn't move the screen there. There it is. Okay, it's in the middle. There's a swing. Yeah. It switches from each side. Okay, I see it. Now, pitch count, 22 pitches for Rania. I was looking on the left side. So folks, here's something to note. When the opposite team is playing, their pitch count highlights. When we go back over to Prairie View side, then it highlights there. So they're not actually pitching there, so their numbers are not up there. There's a ground ball. Tally, man, with a great backup for the second out. Good job by Talia Tally. Man, she's quick. Now batting for the Texas Southern Tigers, the second baseman, number 17, Jordan McLean. Rania throwing a strike. Comes into the game with a 6-5 win-loss average. 1-6, lost 5 for the Panthers this year. She's hit 3 home runs, 64 hits, 42 runs, 28 errors, but 64 hits. One and one to count. Game one, ladies and gentlemen, if you've just checked in. 2-2 the count. Well, we've got the static gnome plaguing us again today. Thought we had all that pretty much figured out. Here's a swing and another foul ball. Pardon us, folks. Yeah, see, there's something going on probably with this. It's now the right side's not working. Two and two the count. Two outs, folks. The Tigers lead by one at the top of the second inning. Rainier with a windup. Pop fly going left field. Nunez gets it easily. And the Panthers will come in to bat. Headed to the bottom of the second inning, ladies and gentlemen. Zero runs, zero hits, zero errors, and zero persons left on base. Stick around, folks. We'll take a quick break. We'll go ahead and talk to our AD here for a second and come back with the bottom of the number two. This is exciting Panther softball.
PB Nation, this is Anton Goff, your athletic director. I want to alert you to an update we are making to our website, pbpanthers.com. It's called Ask the AD. This will allow you to contact me directly, and then I will be able to answer your questions via email or via video. So reach out to us and ask the AD.
Welcome back to Prairie View, Texas, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the order for the Panthers. Tally, Fleming, Garcia, and Nunez. Now batting for the Panthers. The second baseman, number 56.
Aaron Tally.
That one across the middle. It's a strike. Twenty-four pitches from Aaron Berger. One strikeout. That one's high. Tally pulls back 2-1 here. That's a swing and a miss. What a strikeout. And I, my golly gee, mentioned only one strikeout for Maren Berger, and she gets tallied.
shine and come get it. Welcome with Christ, moving where it's gritty.
Well, folks, the call was, is an interference or what? She ran into her, didn't get the call. What's? Oh, wow. Now batting for the Panthers, the center fielder, number one, Audrey Garcia. Garcia takes a ball. Two outs here, no runners on. And that's a strike. 1-1 the count. There's another swing and a grounder. Should be easy and an error. We'll get back on. Second baseman couldn't hold on to it. Right in the hands, right in the glove there of second baseman Jordan McClain. She couldn't hold on to it. We get a runner on. Now batting for the Panthers, all the way from Navasota, Texas. The left fielder, number 22, Mia Nunez. Panthers with a goose egg on the board. That one's coming across the middle of the strike. Folks, if you are watching, man, I tell you, the home plate angle is incredible. Especially with the replay. I had quite a few people to contact me yesterday and said, man, it's the stats and the home plate camera is incredible, man. And I tell you, we really sincerely thank you. Don't forget, again, tell 10 friends to tell 10. To tell 10 about exciting Panther sports right here on the Prairie View A&M YouTube channel. At PVAMU Athletics. That one's inside. Thinking about it, he's going to call it a ball. 2-1 to count. Nice grounder to the third baseman, and we'll have two on. Hit the glove, call it here. And call that one a hit. Now batting for the Panthers. She's got a trigger. The shortstop, number 24, Destiny Smith. Smith with a slugger percentage, .306, 72 at bats this year, 16 hits, and that one is a strike. 13 runs, 11 RBIs, and 13 times she was striked out. Four doubles, though, a triple, and one sacrifice fly, the dossier for the shotgun and the foul ball. We talked to her yesterday. We talked about watching her swing in motion. And Coach Joseph Lane says she had an issue with picking up her back foot. And I just saw him pat his right leg or his left leg there, which is her plant foot. And we'll see if she picks that foot up. Here comes pitch 41. That one inside, a swing and a foul ball. 1-2 the count. The Panthers with two on, first and second. Folks, season tickets for exciting Panther football are on sale right now. All you got to do is go to our website, www.ppanthers.com. Highlight the ticket icon. Drop down box to tell you how to follow the instructions. Great, oh, right into the hands of the pitcher. And Smith just couldn't straighten it out. Folks, headed to the top of the third inning. Zero runs, one hit, one error, two left on base. Zero runs, one hit, one error, and two left on base. For all of the up-to-the-minute update information on Prairie View Athletics, visit the Prairie View A&M University website at www.pvpanthers.com. For all the up-to-date information. Did I say minute? Up-to-date, up-to-the-minute? You know, it might be, you know, I should maybe grab these things and put them on. Folks, stick around. We'll take a quick break and come back with the top of the third inning. The Panthers down 1-0.
PV Nation, this is Anton Goff, your athletic director. I want to alert you to an update we are making to our website, pvpanthers.com. It's called Ask the AD. This will allow you to contact me directly, and then I will be able to answer your questions via email or via video. So reach out to us and ask the AD.
Here's a lineup for the Texas Southern Tigers. Sweeney, Johnson, Zuniga, and Garcia. In the box for the Tigers now, the third baseman, number 25, Jalen Sweeney. Welcome back to Prairie View, Texas, ladies and gentlemen. The Tigers at bat here in the top of the third inning. Brianna Rainey, there's a bunt, easy bunt, and she's safe. Garza got to it, didn't get it to tally in time. Back to the top of the order. Now batting for the Tigers, the center fielder, number 13, Paris Johnson. Tigers with a runner at first here. No outs. Top of the third, Johnson's in the box. Now with this defense, Aaron Talley is cheating over towards second base when the Tigers show bunt, but that leaves a big gap right up the center field line. That one going to Smith with a shotgun. Save! Oh, no! Wait a minute. Well, wait a minute. What's going on? Now the official is... Okay, what happened? Hey, here we go, turn it. Okay, the batter's coming back. What's the call? Well, at any rate, he's showing what was the call? The pitch count? He just put it up. I missed it. 1-1. Okay, 1-1. There's a foul ball, so now that should make it 1-2. There we go. 1-2 the count. That one's high. Brianna Rainier, pitch 35. It's a hot line right in the middle. And Smith dives for it, can't get it. Right between second base and the shortstop position. Right up the middle. And the Panthers' defense seems to be a little off this afternoon. And the Panthers pull a powwow. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you of the big event going on April 13th. It's the annual spring football game, the purple and gold football game right here from Panther Stadium. It's going to be a festive weekend. The whole weekend is going to be kind of like last weekend when we had the PV Relays, the 90th running of the Prairie View Relays, very successful event. More high schools than I think I've seen in the PV Relays, man, in quite some time. And, of course, we had the Texas Southern Tigers playing baseball, a big game, too, on yesterday. And, just a lot of activity going on here in Pantherland. Food trucks everywhere, music going everywhere. Lewis Easley had a car show right off of Owens Road that was just phenomenal. And it's going to be very similar to this weekend. Going to have the Panther Plaza, going to be booths in the tailgate area. We're going to have the Marching Storm out there performing. KPBU is going to be out there, Ms. Thurston. A couple of other things we got to look forward to. I know the Department of Agriculture will be out there with their big truck. And it's going to be a lot of fun. So you've got softball and football right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M the weekend of April 13th. That's the 12th, 13th right here in Pantherland. That's a strike. And Panthers down 1-0. Also want to let you know season tickets are on sale. Trying to sell out our season ticket section. We'll try to provide you with an update next week on how we're doing with that. I'll give you Ms. Thurston's cell phone number. You can call it. No, I'm just teasing. Here we go. Great bunt down the third baseline. No, it's going foul. She said she's she said she's not in tickets. She can't tell you. But we're just going to do that just so we can annoy her. Right, that's all. Just call. Everybody call her. Here's the number. 1-2 the count. 1-0, folks. Top of the third. Swing, and that's a tip. Yeah, she's out of there. A tip, I heard it from way up here. That's that great crowd noise, Mike, that you kind of engineered there. Donald Carroll. James Crenshaw, we need some boom mics for the crowd noise. Pull out the card. Send it airmail. That's going to be a ball across the right side. Garcia in the box for Texas Southern. Pardon me. Charisma Garcia in the box. She was kind of standing right here between this little pillar where I can't see. There's a swing. Rainier gets it. That should be easy. That inside out. But the runners advance to second and third. And now, here comes the first base person. Now batting for Texas Southern, number 37, Angel Morales. Pitch 44 is a strike for Brianna Rainier. Nice crowd out here. Really nice crowd out here for a hazy Saturday afternoon. 1-1 the count. That's a ball. Henderson wants to ease in here. Is that Henderson there? 28. That's a Sweeney on third. Here's the windup, and the pitch right across the middle. It's a strike. 1-2 the count. That's a Sweeney, 25. On third. Check it out. That one's high outside. Two and two the count. Little League Day here on the campus of Prairie View A&M. Several little league teams out having fun. I bet you Sodexo didn't realize that there is a grounder tally that retires the side, no score. Woo. Folks, headed to the bottom of the third inning. 0 runs, 2 hits, 0 errors, and 2 left on base. 0 runs, 2 hits, 0 errors, 2 left on base. Folks, stick around. We'll take a break and come back. When we come back, the Panthers will be in the box here in Prairie View, Texas. Stick around.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to Prairie View, Texas. Here's the lineup for the Panthers. Figueroa, Davis, Garza, and McKnight. Now batting for the Panthers. All the way from Natalia, Texas, 45 miles from the Medina Dam. It's the catcher. Numbers in, Viviana Figueroa. Fig takes a strike on pitch number 46 for Marin Berger. Berger is a freshman from Snowflake, Arizona. Popular place, Snowflake, Arizona. You ever heard of it there, HH? Really? Oh, I was about to say, wow, isn't that something? I've heard about the movie Snowflake. Snow, yeah. What's the other snow movie about the, is it the Snowfall? Is that it? The show, yeah, Snowfall, okay. Yeah. What are you giggling at, John? I mean, you're so lame. We're pretty much watching Family Feud every night. That's what we've been reduced to, and that's going to be ball 4. And Figueroa will take a base. Some come for the softball. I come for the atmosphere. Batting for the Panthers. The third baseman, number 21, Jalen Davis. Gonna get a shimmy. That one's on the inside. Almost had it there. Trying to get that shimmy down. She was about to do it. I was just a tad bit tardy. I need to scoot over. This thing is in my way. Here we go, right across the middle. Beautiful pitch with a strike. 1-2 the count. Folks, the Tigers up 1-0 in the bottom of the third inning. Panthers. There's a swing, ooh man, a hot line right to the, and JD will get on first, one out. Davis is safe at first, but a hot line right to the pitcher, Berger, with a good set of hands. Now batting for the Panthers. The first baseman, number 30, Hanna Garza. Gonna get a pitch runner. Is that gonna be Nia Brown running for Davis? Who is that? Or Ariana Cruz? Which one is it? 5 or 9? It's gonna be 9, ladies and gentlemen. Pitch running for the Panthers. A freshman from Angleton, Texas. Number 9, Ariana Cruz. Well, let's do it again. Garza gives me the thumbs up. In the box for the Panthers, number 30, Hanna Garza. Well, she's going to hit a home run because she got 2 walk-up introductions. So let's see what she's going to do with that. Runner at first. Garza takes a ball. Left corner. McKnight waiting in the wings. That's a strike. That one's high ball, two. Well, tomorrow is celebration of the resurrection, and a lot of people are off this weekend. I guess the broadcast crew wants to wish everybody a happy Easter and a safe Easter or holiday. Let's just say that way, holiday. No? We're going over HH's. She's cooking macaroni and cheese tomorrow. Oh, you're selling plates. First you were cooking yesterday, now you're selling plates? You got to cook to sell, you sure do. Go ahead on. Well, that's that L.A. tire. That's that Oakland, California. You got to cook to sell. There's a swing and a foul ball. See, I almost got in trouble giving you our macaroni and cheese recipe. A lot of people on the hill over there, man. This is just great. Folks, if you've ever been to Panther Stadium, to the right, or to the women's softball complex, let me say that, to the right is the softball complex, soccer complex, and man, it's a nice feat there. It's got a nice hill there. It's a hit, a grounder right up front, and it's going to be an out. We'll advance the runner, though, to second, and now here comes another slugger, Tamira McKnight, the designated hitter. Not bad for the Panthers. The designated hitter, number 29, Tamira McKnight. Folks, I guess if you're a student living here in the Prairie View area and you want area and you need to buy you some Easter dinner, just call Hanaya Hiawatha, huge, and she'll get you done. Well, what's on the menu? Smothered chicken and rice and macaroni and cheese. What's green? And green beans. Hallelujah. Sound like a funeral. Well, without the, you don't get the rice and gravy. You'll get the chicken, green beans, and potato salad. That's the traditional funeral food. One to nothing, folks. Two balls, no strikes, two outs for the Tigers. Tamira McKnight is in the box. How much you selling those dinners for? $15. That's a deal. Are they going to be regular plates or healthy plates? Healthy means, I'll show you a healthy plate. Yeah, portion-wise. Oh, right across the middle, that's a strike. Saw that one from here. So support one of our crew members. Now that one's inside, strike two. Two and two the count. Oh, that one's high. It's going to be a full count. Full count. Well, three balls, two strikes, two outs. This is going to decide this inning. Unless it goes over the fence. That's what you need. McKnight now in the box, folks. Burgers wind up. Inside. Good eye. And here comes Aaron Talley. All the way from Spencer, Oklahoma. It's kind of close to Durant. The second baseman, number 56, Aaron Talley. Want to send a shout out to Talia Talley, if she's watching or listening. Ball one, ball two. want to send a shout out to Miss Antoinette Seals. I guess she's in Spencer, Mama Seals. And this is the most active home plate umpire I've seen in some time. I thought Miss Thurston would get a kick out of that. He's giving warnings. What is he doing? Well, Joseph Lane is just kind of looking over there befuddled. I don't know. Folks, while we got him in, let you know about our all-star team here in the press box. Donald Carroll with Woodlawn Entertainment. Now, Jamarcus, I almost called you Jamarcus Graves, who played basketball here, who had a very similar hairstyle that you did. But last, what's your last name? I'm sorry again. Caldwell. Think of that, darn it. Jamarcus Waco? Arlington? Garland, that's right. They don't do those kinds of things in Garland, Texas. I forgot. Shame on me. One of our superlative students. Well, I knew it was Jamarcus. Here's a swing and a foul ball. Okay. Two, two, two. There's a swing and a foul ball. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Runner at first and second. Tally's trying to get a couple of people in and add to her ERA. Two and two the count. Here comes the windup and the pitch. Oh, she hesitated. And she's out of there. She hesitated there on the swing. And Ms. Thurston watching it too. At the end of the third inning, ladies and gentlemen, zero runs, zero hits, zero errors, and two left on base. Your score, the Lady Tigers won, the Panthers zero. Hey folks, the Lady Panthers golf team will be in action April 1st and 2nd in Katy, Texas, when they compete in the Women in Golf Classic. Let's wish the ladies good luck. Go Panthers! I'm so silly. Stick around, folks. We'll be back with more exciting Panther sports.
We would love to invite y'all on April 13th for a day full of fun and activities, starting at 10 a.m. with the Panther Zone.
Also, starting at 11 o'clock, it's the alumni game, where you can also come by here in Panther Stadium and watch the Purple and Gold game.
And then to cap off the night, we'd like to invite y'all to a concert at 5:30 at Lot 95 right behind Hobart. Come see y'all there.
Go Panthers!
Welcome back to Prairie View, Texas. Here's the order for Texas Southern. Here's the order for the Texas Southern Tigers. Henderson and Richardson. Henderson in the box. Henderson, Richardson, folks, and Perla. And there's a pop fly up easy to Aaron Talley, one out. Here comes Henderson, the right fielder. Now batting for Texas Southern, the right fielder, number six, Pamela Richardson. Richardson, Perla McLean, Charles, pardon me. That's for good luck. She has a, she only wants to use her water cup only. And it's reusable. Could be. Ball one. For Richardson, she is all out the box. Pamela Richardson, a senior from Galveston, Texas, Clear Creek High School product. Uh-oh, and that's a strike, yeah. This is really an animated home basement. 1-1 to count. Reyes, 52nd pitch coming down the pipe. It's a nice slap there to the right fielder, Fleming, right on top of it. One out. Here, folks, in the top of the fourth inning. Reyes wind up. Marissa Perla, the shortstop in the box for Texas Southern. Perla. With a wind up and a swing and a foul ball. One and one the count with one out. One's across the board, number seven up. A swing and a foul ball. Well, this is the first opportunity, Ms. Thurston, I get to bring my granddaughter up here for to play at Prairie View, and she is having the time of her life. I got that pawpaw radar. I'm looking at it right there. A swing and a pop fly. Nunez, pardon me, Garcia in the middle. Should be easy. It was. Now batting for Texas Southern, the second baseman, number 17, Jordan McClain. Folks, keep it locked right here. Game two slated for 2 o'clock. Doubleheader action. Coming your way, the Panthers lead the series 1-0. Here comes Reyna's pitch. Reyna at 58 pitches. Here in the top of the fourth. That's a strike. Well, I bet you Sodexo didn't expect this kind of crowd there, Ms. Thurston. We're going to have to go back for reinforcements. Here's the pitch. That one's high. She's going to try to go. McKnight gets her. Yeah. Actually, the shotgun with the tag. And the Panthers with a good inning. Heading to the bottom of the fourth inning, ladies and gentlemen. 0 runs, 1 hit, 0 errors, and 0 left on base. 0 runs, 1 hit, 0 errors, and nobody left on base at the bottom of the fourth inning. With your score, Texas Southern 1, the Panthers 0. Well, ladies and gentlemen, stick around. We'll take a quick one. We'll take a quick one and come back, or will we stay here? No, stay here. We'll stay here, ladies and gentlemen, tell you about season tickets being on sale here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University for the 2024-25 Panther football season. You got to get your tickets now. We are just trying to make sure, just trying to make sure that we sell out our season ticket seats. Here's the lineup for the Prairie View A&M University Lady Panthers. Ladies and gentlemen, Audrey Fleming, Garcia, Nunez, and Smith. Fleming, Garcia, Nunez, and Smith. Okay, that's seven. I've counted seven times I said ill, ladies and gentlemen. You're supposed to be on your job here. That's a strike coming down the middle. We're going to have to start fining Donald Carroll for not being on his job. Smelled that green nod, lady couldn't resist. Here we go with the windup. Burgers, pitches high. So here's the next question, folks. What was your favorite childhood candy? We'll talk about it in a second. Right, the hotline right up the middle. Great job. Now, batting for the Panthers. Not many gets by. She can go get it. The center fielder, number one, Audrey Garcia. Garcia with a bunt right there in front plate. Oh, we advance the runner. But a beautiful bunt spin right there in front of home plate. Catcher with a good job. Now batting for the Panthers. All the way from Navajo, Texas. Home of the Rattlers. It's our center left fielder, Mia Nunez. Let off. That little tie turn there. She'll take a strike. They start off real slow and then they run into the box. Like they're going to ease up and then here they go. Left side, that's going to be a ball. I got you. There's a swing, and it's going to be a high pop fly, easy peasy to the first baseman, two away. The Panthers going to have to do something. We're going to make a batter substitution. Cisneros coming in the bat. Karina Cisneros, the senior from San Benito, Texas. Now batting for the Panthers, pitch hitting. Senior from San Benito, Texas, number 13, Karina Cisneros. Well, Bland trying to get some hits in here. Panthers have one on base. Cisneros stepping in. Cisneros with 18 at-bats this year. Four hits, a run, and an RBI. Struck out four times. That's a ball. She'll watch it. That's a ball. Berger. 79 pitches. That one beautiful right across the plate for a strike. That's a strike. Two and two the count. Twos across the board. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Here comes the pitch. And that one's going to drop. Yeah, here the Panthers going to tie it up here. And coming in to score for the Panthers is Audrey Fleming. Yeah, baby. Kaboom. That's all we needed to start this hit parade. Now batting for the Panthers. All the way from Natalia, Texas. Number 10, the catcher, Viviana Figueroa. Who's pinch hitting? Who's pinch running? 24? Okay, wow. She wants to speed in there. We talked about it earlier. Now pinch running for the Panthers, number 24, Destiny Smith. Talked about it earlier. Destiny Smith last year was a pretty good base stealer. Hadn't seen her attempt many bases stolen this year. So my classmate must be reading my mind. Oh, Figueroa with a swing and a miss. Tied at one here, ladies and gentlemen. There's a swing. Oh, Figueroa, man, with a nice shot there and a great catch, a great play by the third baseman, Jalen Sweeney, for Texas Southern. Sweeney, the senior from Harker Heights, Texas. Man, what a play. Heading to the top of the fifth inning, ladies and gentlemen. Again, heading to the top of the fifth inning, ladies and gentlemen. One run, two hits, zero errors, and one left on base. 1-2-0-1. At the end of the fourth inning, the Lady Panthers and the Lady Tigers are tied at one. Stick around, ladies and gentlemen. We'll take a break and come back with more exciting women's softball.
We would love to invite y'all on April 13th for a day full of fun and activities, starting at 10 a.m. with the Panther Zone.
Also, starting at 11 o'clock, it's the alumni game, where you can also come by here in Panther Stadium and watch the Purple and Gold game.
And then to cap off the night, we'd like to invite y'all to a concert at 5:30 at Lot 95 right behind Hobart. Let's see y'all there.
Go Panthers!
Welcome back to Prairie View, Texas, ladies and gentlemen. The entire Panther sports broadcast team today, Hanaya Hiawatha Hughes. It's really not Hiawatha Hughes. That's her DJ name I gave her. From Oakland, California, Trez Montague is somewhere around here from PG County, Maryland, taking pictures. Donald Carroll, our producer from Woodlawn Entertainment, Charlie Henry, and Jamarcus Cotwell, all the way from Garland, Texas, where they just don't do anything. Tied at one. In the box for Texas Southern is Jordan McClain. McClain batting for the Tigers. The second base person back in. Here's the windup. That one's inside. It's a ball. Rainier with came in with 68 pitches. Wait, folks. 64 pitches. Again, we just can't reiterate just the beauty and the ease of navigation for our webpage. And I'll tell you about it in a minute. That's going to be another ball. www.pbpanthers.com is where you need to go. You can get live stats, up-to-the-minute information, interviews, rosters, a whole lot more. It's at pbpanthers.com. That one's inside, and she's going to take a base. Well, Rainya, after pitch 62, trying to find out, okay, where are the walks at there, Ms. Thurston? Four, walked four today? That should be a strike, yeah. Owen won the count. Here's the bunt. No. Did it cross the plate? No. 1-1 to count. That's an out. Good job, Figueroa, man, with the speed, 1-0. They advance a runner, though, to second base. A lot of strategy going on. Strategy, folks, just teasing. Thetis would get me. Hair in the way. Now batting number 13. I was being quiet because I know. Pardon me, folks. Now batting for Texas Southern. Number 13, the center fielder, Paris Johnson. I was trying to find the number of walks on here when you get a chance, Miss Thurston, for the pitcher. Is it BB or BB? Oh, that's two walks, okay. Balls on base. I've been studying. You said I never studied. Folks, don't forget, game two coming about 30 minutes after this one. Is it 20 or 30 that we take a break? And 2 o'clock is the first pitch for game two. The Panthers will hit the road next week. Then wind up back in Pantherland here to take on Southern University April 12th and 13th. They'll play Incarnate Word on Wednesday, April 10th. And there's a swing and a great catch and 2-0 double play, JD. Wow. Beautiful play. Jalen Davis catches the line drive, gets it back to first base. Retired aside. Second base, pardon me. 0-0-0-0-0. No, I'm just teasing. The numbers. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the fifth inning stretch. What's the numbers there, LT? Oh, no, Crawford. At the end of the top of the fifth inning, 0 runs, 0 hits, 0 errors. No one left on base. We're tied at 1. Now, the fifth inning stretch, we've got to get these people involved in it. This take me out to the ballgame. It's not really getting the crowd involved. We need to play Boogie Wonderland, maybe. What else is a good one? What do you think, Donald Carroll? That's universal. That'll get all ages into this one. Bunny Hop. Okay, the Bunny Hop, yeah. The Cupid Shuffle, yeah, that would be a good one. Hey, how about Let It Whip, huh? The Dance Band? I want to see you whip. This evening, he started dancing, yeah. He's dancing. Boom. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're headed to the bottom of the fifth. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's join in. Come on, it's the fifth inning stretch. Let's have a little fun. Come on. Some come for the atmosphere. I come for the softball. Now batting the third baseman. That's okay. We're going to get our rhythm down in a minute, DJ Hiawatha. Jalen Davis. We just need to shorten down that intro. We used to have it on time. It's the same cut, isn't it? There's a swing. No. Well, usually when they start there, we try to start when they're in the this one particular song, though. It's just, it's her deal. Just trying to get on the rhythm. I'm a little late. Okay, I'm a little late. Swing and a miss. I'm late. All right, folks. 1-2 the count, folks. No outs for the Panthers. Come on, JD. That one's outside. 2-2 to count. Good eye. Hannah Garza on deck for the Panthers. Uh-oh. Oh, there's a swing and a foul ball. That one right across the middle. Looked good. Looked appetizing enough for Davis. Want to send a shout out to everyone who attended and supported the Houston Chapel of the Prairie View A&M University. And that one bounced foul. The Prairie View A&M University National Alumni Association Houston chapter had their annual scholarship fish fry on yesterday. Tickets were $25. I told Holly, if you sold 40 dinners, I know you sold, you made $1,000. So depending on how much y'all spent, and knowing Miss Wanda, she's been buying catfish all year, they should have done pretty well. Davis! Oh, man, that one looked good. Right across the middle, I think. Did you see that? Two and two to count. Davis showing bunt. And foul ball. 93 pitches for Marin Berger today. She's been on the mound all game. Bottom of the fifth. We've got two more to go. Will she finish the game? 2-2 to count. And that's a ball. Good eye. Full count. Well, let's see what JD's going to do. That's a ball. Good eye. Davis takes the base. Here comes Hannah Garza. Now batting for the Panthers. Number 30, Hannah Garza. First base person, Hannah Garza. Get this out of here. There we go. Garza showing bunt, ball one. Students, if you're watching, you want to get a home-cooked meal today, tomorrow for Easter, we'll tell you how to get one. That's going to be a ball. 2-0 the count. Now, you can either go get smothered chicken, rice, green beans, and macaroni and cheese, or you can come over and get, please come home, I've got beans and bologna. That's a ball. Nope, strike, he got it. Okay, there we go. That's a ball. Now that one looked good. 3-1 to count. That's a swing and a grounder. The Panthers will advance. Jalen Davis. And now here comes McKnight. Now batting for the Panthers. The designated hitter, number 29, Tamara McKnight. Now that's on time, see. You gotta hurry up, Charles. Folks, the Panthers baseball team getting ready to play at 3:00 today. Lost yesterday 7-5 in game one. They'll play another one tomorrow at 1:00. We'll try to keep you updated. Well, we should be almost done when they start at 3:00. We'll keep you updated. If you need to be updated, go to www.pbpanthers.com. Same way you got the live stats for this game, you can get the live stats for, nope, we can use the force. And we can go to NCAA stats. And nope, can't go to NCAA. You're just going to have to wait, huh? Okay, well, yeah, Southern, we're not going to throw no rocks and everything, but sometimes they're just a little tardy in uploading stats. So I guess you're just going to have to wait and see. Here you go. There's a nice slap there from McKnight. Goes foul out of bounds. Yeah, we don't. We still don't have the stats from yesterday. We just got the score. Not her school, not her job. She don't even care if it's Alabama State. Oh, we're not going to mention that. All right, folks. 1-2 to count. One out. Oh, there's a grounder, and they've been really playing. Oh, JD gets in there. She's safe. And, yeah, great play. And here comes some strategy from Vernon Bland. We're going to get some pinch runners. Here comes Cadence Martin. Is that? No, that's Kaylin Massey's coming. Okay. 25 coming up to bat. Pinch hitting for Prairie View A&M. We're going to have to wait until the official officially rolls us in. And then we're going 15. Pinch running for the Panthers, number 15, Jay Guristi. And pinch hitting for the Panthers, number 25, Kaylin Massey. Well, that must be Massey's homies. Get him, Massey. We got to make up something. Let's do it right. Now batting for the Panthers. All the way from Fort Smith, Arkansas. Number 25, Kaylin Massey. Now she's going to hit her. Yeah, Alexi started to shake there and shimmy. That's her song. Knock it out of the box. No. Wouldn't that be something if, I know, yeah, exactly. Kaylin Massey on the year batting 500, 4-0. As a pitcher. Now, oh, man. And it hit the base. All right, hit home plate, so it's a foul ball. Did he bail her out or did it hit home plate? It hit home plate, okay. Massey trying to hit the ball over there by the Texas Southern bus. 0-2 the count. Massey hanging in the box. One out. We're tied at one. That one's a ball. 1-2 the count. There's another swing. That one's inside. And Coach Vernon Bland over there with the hotline. He's got to be careful over there. Pitch number 105, and man, Massey, man, if she could have just straightened that one out a little bit, it would have been a little shallow of 200. But Massey now, 1-2 again. That one's outside. Good eye, Massey. That's going to make it a full count, huh? Oh, 2-2? Boy, he's quick over there. Jamal, I tell you, Brother Caldwell is quick with those strikes and balls. I didn't get even a chance to look. All right, here we go. 2-2 to count. Pitch number 107. That one's going deep, and it's going to be a foul ball. And she just straightens that one out just a tad. Two and two to count. Massey's been in the box a minute here. All right, pitch number 106. 12? Mine's a little behind. Okay, 112. There's one. Oh, good slap. Fielder's choice. He'll take second base. We'll get a runner at one and one at third. And now here comes Audrey Fleming. Now batting for the Panthers. Number 26, the right fielder, Audrey Fleming. Okay, they held me up. I didn't know what was going on there. Bland making a substitution. He's taking JD, huh? 5 for 25? Five, yeah. Okay, so Nia Brown is going to come and run for, or Nia Brown, yeah, is going to come and run for Massey. Massey just in for her stick. And now she'll come and take a seat. Massey, not only a pitcher, but a utility player. Now batting for the Panthers, number 26, Autry Fleming. Runners at first and third. Two outs, folks. The Panthers tied at one. The bottom of the fifth inning. Oh, and here we come in, Jade. And an error will score. Jalen Davis. Man, I tell you, what an intense game, man. This is worth the price of a ticket, folks. You should have got here. If not, man, you need to call everybody and say, hey, this is a great softball game between two very good teams and arch rivals. One and one to count? Okay, he's got one and one to count. Ooh, strike right across the middle. That's a swing. It's up high, right to left side, and it's an easy one. And kind of looked like a center fielder had a sigh of relief when she caught that one, Paris Johnson. As she watched it all the way into the glove, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the fifth inning. One run, one hit, one error, one left on base. The end of the fifth. Your score, the Lady Tigers won. The Panthers, two. Stick around, folks. We'll take a break. Come back with the top of the sixth inning. This is exciting women's softball on the Prairie View A&M University Athletics YouTube channel.
We would love to invite y'all on April 13th for a day full of fun and activities, starting at 10 a.m. with the Panther Zone.
Also, starting at 11 o'clock, it's the alumni game, where you can also come by here in Panther Stadium and watch the Purple and Gold game.
And then to cap off the night, we'd like to invite y'all to a concert at 5:30 at Lot 95 right behind Hobart. Let's see y'all there.
Go Panthers!
We're back live here in Prairie View, Texas. Are we back live here? I'm not letting you do your job, am I? Donald Carroll. Pinch hitting here. Now they're pulling out the big guns. Number 16 headed in for Madison Griggs, a senior from Los Angeles, California. Now batting for Texas Southern, a senior from Los Angeles, California. Number 16, Madison Griggs. Rainya headed in to pitch number. This one has 72 pitches. Imagine 72 pitches. Not as many pitches thrown by Rainya as Berger. Ball one. Here comes the pitch. Right across the middle. That's a strike for Griggs. Yeah, she's, well, have her listed at 5'10", but she looks almost 6 feet. She is a tall young lady. Here's a swing and a miss. Rainya gets it with two strikes. Here comes pitch number 72. 1-2 the count. No outs, top of the sixth. That one a ball. Two and two the count. And she got her. Reyna now with three strikeouts today. Now batting for Texas Southern. The catcher, number 28, Charisma Garcia. Ladies and gentlemen, our goal was 1,000 views this weekend for all three games. Of course, I've got lofty goals. I wanted about 1,600 for the whole weekend, but we know it's a holiday and people are moving around and trying to get ready for tomorrow. So you can watch these games at any time. If you go to our YouTube page, you know, Ms. Thurston and her team over there has got it pretty simple. I mean, you can watch any game that we've videoed all year. All you got to do is click on it. Doesn't do anything but give us another view, and we appreciate it. Tell a friend to tell 10 friends about how exciting it is in Pantherland. Two balls, no strikes, one out. Top of the sixth. Rainier's 77th pitch about to come down the pipe. Here it comes. That's a strike right across the middle. Well, I'm looking at the stats. As if you look at the stat ticker, it'll say that she's had four at-bats all year. Garcia, the catcher, that can't be right. It says at-bats, it says season. Is that the date? Tally. Is that for yesterday and today? Because it says season there. I'm just trying to explain the stats to you folks as we learn it. Moved them down. Okay, so in the program, you got to put something in there if you're going to use it. So the stats from yesterday are today's stats. That's real smart. Four at-bats as of yesterday and today. That's just TSU. That's not the whole year. But just so the information is in there, that's pretty smart. Now batting for the Tigers, the first baseman, number 37, Angel Morales. Morales with four at-bats and a hit, two RBIs and a walk for the series. Today, two at-bats. This is number three. That one's a strike right across the middle, yeah. Tied at one. There's a swing and a foul ball. They're going to try to. Mentally's trying to chase it down. Mentally's got some jets. That second base position is really, really important. Oh, man, a nice slap to mid-center. And it's going to go all the way deep to 220. And a double. Garcia. Or Morales, rather, with a nice slap to center field. Now getting ready to get in the box for the Panthers to designate the hitter, Sanaya Henderson. In the box for the Panthers, the designated hitter, pardon me, for the Tigers, the designated hitter, number four, Sanaya Henderson, pinch running for the Tigers. Number five, a sophomore from Abilene, Texas, Lene Carr. I did say Abilene, didn't I? All right, so now the Panthers with two outs and the Tigers with a tying run on second base. That one across the middle, beautiful pitch for Rainier, pitch number 85. That one outside. One and one the count. There's a swing right up the middle to the shotgun, and she's out of there. The Panthers retire the side. Headed to the bottom of the sixth. Zero runs, one hit, zero errors, and one left on base. Zero runs, one hit, zero errors, and one left on base. Hey, folks, softball will return to action on Tuesday, April 2nd, when they face the Aggies of Texas A&M for a 6 p.m. first pitch in Bryan College Station, Texas, inside of Davis Diamond. Go Panthers! Here's the order for Prairie View and Dem, ladies and gentlemen. Garcia, Nunez, Smith, and Figueroa, the lineup for the Panthers. I want to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, the specialists at Houston Methodist and Orthopedics and Sports Medicine are proud to be the official provider of Prairie View University Athletics Healthcare. The specialists at Houston Methodist and Orthopedics and Sports Medicine at Willowbrook. I'd like to thank them for all they do. All right, we're looking for Garcia. Now batting for the Panthers, all the way from Katy, Texas. Number one, the left fielder. Pardon me, number one, the center fielder, Audrey Garcia. That one's outside, ball two. Garcia with a sacrifice fly in the fourth. And that one comes across the middle with a strike. A double there in the second inning for Garcia. And sacrifice fly in the fourth inning. 54 at-bats for Garcia. 19 hits, 13 runs, 11 RBIs, 9 walks, and 11 strikeouts for the standout from Katy. A swing and a foul ball. Full count.
Full count.
There's a swing, man, and a line drive foul low. Angel Morales was closest to it. And now Garcia back in the box with a full count. And she'll take her base. Now heading for the Panthers. All the way down from Navasota, Texas. Left fielder, number 22, Mia Nunez. Now here comes a pinch runners. Is this 11 coming out? Is this Deanna 17? That's going to be Jordan Fardendino from Queens, New York. Pinch running for the Panthers. All the way from Queens, New York. Number 17, Jordan Fardendino. I asked her if that's the way to say it. She says she's, nope. Okay, yeah, we saw it there, sir. We saw it when you were over there, Mr. Official. Nunez! There we go. Now, we've got to make sure we get that right. Good job, HH. Here we go with the first pitch. It's a swing. She's going to get there. Yes! No! He calls her out. Golly gee, Wilkers. I tell you, that tag goes to the runners just out of the box now. Huh? Now batting for the Panthers. Used to be Seabrook, Nas League City. The shotgun. The shortstop, number 24, Destiny Smith. D. Smith in the box for the Panthers. Foul. Pardon me. Ball. That one looked good from the time it left Berger's hand to the time it got into the catcher's mitt. 126 pitches for Marin Berger from, that's going to be a foul ball. Berger from a Snowflake, Arizona. Now, HH said she used to live it. Uh-oh, here we go. Arizona. I've never heard of Snowflake, Arizona. But big city, little city, what's it famous for? We'll have to look it up at halftime or during the break and see what Snowflake, Arizona. It's the only place it's ever snowed in Arizona, so they call it named it Snowflake. Oh, line drive to the pitcher. That'll advance the runner, Fernandino, to third base. No, I was making something up. I was making that up. You got to know how to. Carol is laughing because she's like, I don't think that's true. No, it wasn't. I just made it up. Now batting for the Panthers. From Natalia, Texas, the catcher, Viviana Figueroa. That one's outside. It's a ball. Fernandino trying to sneak in here. She looks a little sneaky there on third base trying to hit in. There's a foul ball. Two-one to score. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the windup for pitch. Number 127, and everybody's running away. JD's on deck over there saying, hey, hit it that way, Fig. And Vernon Bland and the official and the umpire there, third base umpire, everybody hitting the deck on that one. Figueroa, a left-handed batter. When she bats, everybody goes to the dugout on that side. That's a ball. Oh, there's a nice slap to first base. Morales gets on it now, and the Panthers leave one on base. one. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Headed to the top of the seventh inning. Zero runs, zero hits, zero errors, and one left on base. Good luck to our men and women's track teams as they participate in the 2024 Pepsi Florida Relays. Go Panthers! Top of the seventh inning, ladies and gentlemen. A great crew here. Now, for those of you looking for a plate, now I'm going to go out on the limb. One re-enters. We got, absolutely, sir. We got Latonya Thurston up here. What's wrong with this guy? I'm just teasing. But for those of you who want some good soul food, some good home-cooked food, you need to go to Sadia's Kitchen. Go to Instagram, go to Sadia's Kitchen, and get all the information. It's one of our superlative students, HH, is making an honest living and a hustle. I agree with that. So let's support our students, ladies and gentlemen. And the way she was telling me she was going to prepare it, sounded quite appetizing. We'll have to see. I think I'm going to have to send somebody with a plate just so I can sample and support you. Me and Miss Thurston will come run by your crib and pick our plate up. She told me I got to pick mine up on campus. I can't come by. You pick yours up here by the softball field. All right, is that number six right there? Walking up. Look like Harris, Dark Johnson. Is that Pamela Richardson, number six? Now batting for Texas Southern. Yes or no? Number six, Pamela Richardson. Coming from that way with the long hair, you can't see who's who. Ball one. I'm not saying, look, you see how I got, see how very quiet I got. Yeah. Don gave me the side eye just to see if I was silly enough to even attempt it. I'm not going to do it. There's a bunt there, the first base pig. Figueroa, oh, they call her safe. I don't know. Here comes Vernon Bland out. And let's see. What's the replay? Let's see what Donald Carroll has to say. See what say? Let's see what say. Well, she's coming back to bat. What happened? She stepped out of the box? What could it have been, Miss Thurston? Stepped out of the box. And we had to bring her back. And that's why Bland came out of the dugout, because she stepped out of the box on that one. Okay, so it's 1-1 to count. There's a pop fly to the shotgun. And now it's an easy one. Rodriguez changing it up, a new hitter. Number 12, that's gonna be Madison Battle, a junior from Cypress, Texas. Now batting for the Tigers of Texas Southern, a junior from Cypress, Texas, number 12, Madison Battle. Well, I'm sure, I assume the Battle family, who's really, really near, should be somewhere close cheering old Madison on to victory in the maroon and gray. That's a strike. Folks, are we going to stay here during the break, Donald, or do we have to reload? Are we going to stay or reload? We're going to reload, folks. So after this game, you're going to have to reload for game two. We're going to shut down game one. And then we'll immediately put the link back up for game two. That's how we're going to have to do it. So game two will be a whole different game. We'll do that the same way on the Splendid Media Network. We'll do it both ways. How about that? We're going to play a series of informational commercials and spots right after So we've got an interview going, and we've got a couple of spots going immediately following the game, folks. Stick around for that, and then we'll reload. 30 minutes in between games, Ms. Thurston? Yeah. After the last video, click your timers for 30 minutes and come back. Two balls and a strike with one out. Top of the seventh. That's a tip, and she's out of there. Yeah, she's out of there. Yeah, he tipped it. She tipped it with a bat. She's out. He said, oh. So it has to pop over. It has to go up instead of tip because he called her out once he earlier, but it was a strike. Well, that's a strike over the corner. Well, how about that? I'll take it that way. Okay, strike is a strike. Now batting for Texas Southern, number 17, Jordan McClain. Two outs. Two to one, and see, there you go. Two to one, and the top of the seventh. You said, I thought you said they're going to do it. And meaning, no. I thought I got her. I'm going to tell America if they do. Hey, friends, I'm going to get you back. Drive right across the left corner. One and one the count. Here's the pitch. Rania with 98 pitches. That's what I've gotten here. Are we off a little bit? 98, give or take. 100 pitches, okay. McClain hanging out in the box. That's a ball. Three and one, the count. Strike two. Well, full count. Full count. Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. 3-2-2. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Here's the pitch. And a foul ball. Again, folks, you're going to have to reload for game two. We've got post-game interviews going on immediately following the last pitch. And a couple of informational spots for you, telling you about how you can give and telling you about the spring game, a whole bunch of stuff going on. And then we'll reload for 30 minutes after this game to start game two. 3-2, three balls, two strikes, two outs, a swing, and another foul ball. 104 pitches for Brianna Rania. Rania, the senior from Corpus Christi, Texas. Didn't remember a Lamar High School in Corpus Christi, or did she come from Lamar? Oh, okay, she transferred in from Lamar College. Okay, there we go. There's a swing right there to the shotgun, too easy, and we do it. The Panthers lead the series 2-1 after winning in game two, 2-1. Zeros all the way across. Ladies and gentlemen, to wrap it up, zeros all the way across. Zero runs, zero hits, zero errors. No one left on base. Your final score, game one of today's doubleheader, Texas Southern 1, the Panthers 2. 30-minute intermission, folks. 30-minute intermission. Yeah, stick around, folks, for game two of today's doubleheader. I didn't see that. I apologize. Hey, folks, don't forget, head on over to the concession stand for some ice-cold beverages, hot dogs, candy, and a lot of...
Hey, I'm Jaden here with Panther Vision. I'm joined by...
Coach Brand.
Thank you, Coach. So, how do you feel about the game so far?
We just took the lead this inning, so the game has gotten better. You know, we've left a lot of runners on, but hopefully we can hold this lead and score a couple of more next inning and go on for the win.
Yes, sir. What do you think will be the main focus down the stretch?
Defense now. Got to play defense.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So, Coach.
What's up, baby? Golf?
Hey, I was checking out this 2024 home schedule. Looking good, man. This mm-hmm. is definitely get fans in the stands.
Absolutely. We need fans in the stands, right? To come support our 23 Western Division champions. All right, here. This one we're going to start it right here. August 31st, we got Texas Southern. You guys know that's going to be a huge game, big-time game. We need everybody out there. Then we jump down to September 21st against Southern, big rival game. We play them at home. We got them last year. We'll get them again this year. Then we jump down to October 9th. We got a bye. Then we come to October 26th. We got Texas Commerce for homecoming. We know how we do at homecoming. We need you out there. Go back down. We jump down to November 9th. We got Florida A&M. Played them twice last year, all right? Now we got them first this year. Then we go to November 16th. We finish up with Alcorn.
That's a heck of a season. You know, for me, I got to tell you what time it is.
What time is it?
It's time for PV Nation to buy their home season tickets right now, today. Go to pvpanthers.com. And buy your season tickets today.
Go, go Panthers!
We would love to invite y'all on April 13th for a day full of fun and activities, starting at 10 a.m. with the Panther Zone.
Also, starting at 11 o'clock, it's the alumni game, where you can also come by here in Panther Stadium and watch the purple and gold game.
And then to cap out the night, we'd like to invite y'all to a concert at 5:30 at Lot 95 right behind Hobart. Hope to see y'all there.
Go Panthers!